So, okay, let me not waste time and directly go. Ayurveda, everybody must have heard Ayurveda talks about Panchkarma a lot. In Ayurveda, apart from medications or daily nutrients, we use Panchkarma a lot. It's not only to cure the disease, but it's also for a daily, to keep ourselves fit. So in Panchkarma, we have few kriyas, we call them yoga kriyas, and which can be done daily, which helps us to stay fit. Because, with our normal human being, the human body is capable of healing everything by itself. But our lifestyle, the way we eat our food, we keep on jumping here and there with the food, and our lifestyle and our daily routine, exercise pattern, all these things disturbs the balance. And it becomes a struggle for the body because the disturbance is much faster than the time body can take to recover.
Right.
It is really recommended that we use these kriyas, we make them a part of our daily life, so that we can attain the best. Because, for example, now we are talking about sinus. Olden days, if people had allergies, sinuses, it was okay. We would take medicine, we would manage, do some home remedies and then manage it. But now the minute somebody has got some itching in the nose, the fear comes up.
Yes.
Is there some virus inside and they want something? So why wait for that fear? It's better we start doing some kriyas so that we can strengthen ourselves and we can be rest assured that, okay, we are doing these things, so nothing can happen. That minute virus which has disturbed the whole world cannot disturb our body.
Correct.
So today's session is mostly focused on how to increase your immunity through the kriyas. So we are going to talk about four kriyas. So first kriya I will talk about is Nasya. Nasya is a very, very simple kriya. It's basically nasal drops. So in Ayurveda, not only in Ayurveda, I would say rather in the whole world, we know that nose is the gateway to our head and to our respiratory system. So it's very important to use this gateway and make the maximum. We've also seen, many of the brain surgeries are now done through the nasal passage. They don't even want to open the brain. So, we are lucky enough, we can do it. So why not? So we'll talk about nasal nasya. In nasya, what we do is we can take medicated oil, medicated ghee, and we can put drops into the nose, and we can do it in a way that it goes to the whole of the brain, it circulates in the brain, and it gives its benefits. So see, what happens is, because the nose is directly connected to the brain, the nasal drops, the medications can help to balance the doshas which are imbalanced. It can also help to just detoxify. It can also help to nourish the brain. So, why do we wait? There are diseases nowadays, we hear about Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, fibromyalgia, all such diseases. These are all brain-related diseases. So doing Nasya regularly, we are saying bye-bye, thank you very much, I am doing this, so I don't, these things cannot. I'm talking about these big diseases. But yes, day-to-day, sinusitis, allergic rhinitis, or deviated nasal symptom, or just allergy, just a simple allergy. These are the day-to-day things. You will just forget that you ever suffered from this.
So is this something you do every day, or do you do it, when you're feeling that it could be a problem, or do you do it currently during these times where you know that there's a respiratory illness?
No, so it is the best to do it daily. It is just putting two drops of oil or ghee, depends on person to person. I will explain it later on.
Yeah.
Just two drops of oil or ghee in each nostril. So if you do it daily, then it is like rejuvenating. So you don't have to wait for something to happen.
You mentioned medicated ghee. What is medicated ghee? Shilpa, you mentioned medicated ghee. What is medicated ghee?
So medicated ghee is like in Ayurveda, we use Trifla a lot. Mm-hmm. So there can be, so we get it in the market and we can also make it at home, make a decoction from Trifla, then add it to the ghee and cook it together until the water evaporates completely. So it's called medicated ghee.
Right,
you can only get medicated oil also. So it is a very good treatment, you know, for herniated disc, for paralysis and all that, because we can control the central nervous system through the nose.
And is the ghee a special kind of ghee, or is it something that we can just buy, the regular ghee?
We can just use the normal cow ghee from home.
Okay.
These are the medicated ones which I'm talking about, especially for some, you know, for specific needs.
Right.
But we are going to talk more like, you know, I want you all to do things. So I want to say things which are available at this point.
Right.
So preferably either you use cow ghee or you use sesame oil or mustard oil.
Okay.
Take it in a bottle and make sure you tilt your head up like this. You can do it sitting. You can lie down also, no worries. Tilt your head up and then put two drops. After you put the two drops into your nostrils, just make sure you rub the nostrils so that the oil or the ghee goes inside. Rest there for 2 minutes and then put the drops into the other nostril. Again, rest there. Again, massage it a little bit. Massage it so that the oil has gone inside. Rest for 2 minutes so that everything goes inside. So this, the nasya, what I'm talking about, the nasal drop that I'm talking about, is not only for the nose. It is also for the brain and it is also for the respiratory system. It works 3-in-1.
Right.
So there will not be anything better than this. I'm going to share a small video to just make the procedure more clear to everybody.
Okay, great. And I just show us this. And then in the meantime, we will also have Geeta also has joined us. Hi, Geeta. Welcome.
Hi. I'm so sorry. My net was not working. A very warm welcome to Dr. Shilpa, our own very Dr. Shilpa, who is our great Ayurveda specialist. Am I clear, please?
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm really sorry to join another 5-10 minutes late. So let's start. Yes, Shilpa, please show your video and I'll continue.
Yeah, just a minute. One minute. Something has...
Geeta, I think you are on your mobile phone.
Yes.
So we can see very little of you.
I'm trying to join the meeting by, but it's not happening, but I'll try.
It seems you have bandwidth issues.
Yeah, I think there is some problem. That's why I can only see the mobile.
Right.
Okay, here it goes.
So this is a little video clip that Shilpa will share with us for better understanding.
So if you see, she's put her head down, tilted behind. Now she's taking the two drops of oil and she's putting it into the nostrils. Putting it into the nostrils. So you avoid touching things so that it doesn't get contaminated. Then take deep breath so that the oil goes inside from both the nostrils. Just take deep breath so that the oil can go inside. Massage the nose, pull it inside. And then rest for 2 minutes. So this is the easiest, simplest way. It's not difficult. You can do it for day-to-day practice. It's like, so as I said, you can use ghee. You can normal ghee, normal sesame oil, or normal mustard oil. Preferably these three things. Avoid coconut oil because coconut oil sometimes does not work very well. Coconut oil works well if it is medicated. That means if some other medicines, the herbs are added to it.
Right.
So only
the best is ghee.
The best is cow ghee. It works very well because it is nourishing. We are talking about day-to-day health. So when it is nourishing, we want something to nourish the brain and nourish the nasal passage and the respiratory system. Because the ghee is lubricating, it helps the nasal passage to be clear. Only precaution that we have to take is this should not be done just after taking bath or after food.
Right.
Yes, there is no precaution. And secondly, you should not go into the breeze just after doing it. Just wait for like very windy place. Like you wait for at least 30 minutes before going to windy place. So the best is either you do it in the morning or after dinner, like half an hour after dinner.
Right.
So this is Nasya.
You know, to our audience who are watching it here on live on Zoom as well as on Facebook, if you have any questions, please type them in, or you can raise your hand because there are these reactions where you can raise your hand. And we have Geeta now with us who can help us, you know, ask the questions and even guide this conversation forward.
So, Dr. Shilpa, I had tried this once on your when you had told me, and it's quite easy. There's nothing wrong with it. I had specially taken the home ghee as you had suggested, and I had tried it, and it's quite comfortable. Mm-hmm. I liked it.
Yeah. Good, good, good. Nice to have first in experience, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I know. I remember.
So can we go to the second Kriya? Because, you know, first let's finish off the Kriyas. Meanwhile, the questions will pop up and that will become more easy.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So next Kriya, we'll talk about Jalneti. So before we go ahead, I will just show you the pot. See, this is the Jalneti pot. This is very famous, you know, like everybody knows about this pot.
Yeah.
But so this is the pot. So this is Jalneti pot. That's why. And why is it called Jalneti? Because we use gel. Gel is water. Okay. So before we go and I explain the procedure, let me explain what exactly is Jalneti. Now, in Jalneti, we are passing the water from one nostril. And we either can remove the water from the other nostril or from your mouth. So it is a very simple process, but of course we need guidance. At least one or two times, there should be a supervision. Don't worry, I will tell you what is to be done. Now maybe you will say that, oh, then we can't do it. What is the use of teaching it to us now? So we have a solution for that also. Now, how does it help? Because the water goes inside and it's the saline water that we use, it clears the nasal passage, it helps melt the mucus, it clears the nasal passage. So again, it helps in sinusitis, it helps in any phlegm that is made, it helps in allergic rhinitis. It also helps in hair fall, it also helps in eye problems. So, you know, like these things, they are not only, because we talk about ENT, it's all connected.
Right.
All these things, they help everything. It's not only focused to our nose. And of course, it is the pandemic creator. It helps us to fight with the pandemic also, so that we are not affected, you know. That is why it's very important that we understand this. So what we're going to do is, you're going to take this pot. Inside this pot, we're going to fill this with water, lukewarm water. In one, this is like this much of lukewarm water, you just take 1 teaspoon of salt. Lukewarm water is taken, and then we check our nostrils, which nostril is open. Because at one time we are using one nostril and one is always more stronger than the second one. So we check both the nostrils, and whichever is open or whichever is more stronger, we start from there. And what we do is, if we're doing it in a standing position, we try to do it in front of a basin, or we can have a tub in front of us, and we bend a little bit. We take this pot, we tilt our head, tilt it in such a way that it's try to do it into 90 degrees and a little bit bent. Keep your mouth open so you are breathing throughout when the procedure is going on. Take this, put it into the nostril, and then just start pouring, and you will see the water start. Because you're breathing from the mouth, the water will start coming, pouring from your nostril, one drop, 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 drop. When it becomes half, you just remove it. And remember, to remove all the excess water. So that is, this is very important so that you don't leave the excess water there. And then again, do the same thing immediately after that, do it on the other nostril.
So there is no choking feeling at all when you do this?
No, not at all. The water just flows. Water just flows. See, there is a doubt, you know, people feel that, oh, what happens if the water goes up?
See, there's no place.
There is no harm. No, even if a little bit of water, you know, few drops of water goes, it will come out. You might feel a bit of uncomfortableness, but there is no danger. There is
Does the water come out from the mouth also, Dr. Shilpa?
Yes, yes. So this process can be done in two ways. Either you can bring the water out from the nostril or from the mouth. Nostril is easier. Mouth is, it takes a lot of training. So that's why we're talking about the mouth one.
Yeah, I think if you can't take it out from your mouth, you might tend to cough also because it...
Yeah, so it needs a lot of practice. Once you practice it, then it becomes easier. But otherwise, it's the nose one is very easy. So let me share a video and then we can talk about it more. So luckily, we have Pavitra here. Pavitra is a yoga teacher and he's going to do the... He's done the special recording for us only.
How nice.
You need a Jalnithi pot. Either can take a plastic one or a metallic one. And you need to prepare... you need to prepare 1 liter of saline water. First, take 1 liter of drinking quality water and 1 teaspoon of rock salt or sea salt. Make it lukewarm and then pour it into the neti pot. The method to practice is when you're passing the water in the nostrils, you should open the mouth and keep breathing in the mouth so that water will freely flow into one nostrils to other. So let me demonstrate you how to do it. So neti pot has an opening this side. So you can place the opening into the right nostril first. Once you put it in the right nostril, open the mouth and start breathing.
So we can see the water dripping out from the nostrils clearly.
I thought it was difficult, but I think it's quite comfortable.
Yeah, it's very easy. It's very easy. You know, within a second, it starts flowing out and then you don't even realize and it's done.
So that is the reason for the special shape of the spout, so that the water cannot flow out from the nostril from which you are pouring it in.
No. It doesn't matter. The spout, it's just for us to feel comfortable.
Oh, okay.
It's like designed in such a way, the spout is designed in such a way so that we feel comfortable that it's blocked and we don't push it too much inside and we don't injure ourselves. So see, he's just pushed the water out.
Once you finish one side, you can bend forward and flow. So when you're passing the water, it's also important to keep the nostril horizontal to the flow. So you need to bend, tilt your head so that water will go in one nostril. And it will come in the other nostril. So let's do on the other side. If you want to see how to do it on plastic one, it's same. I can show you.
So we can even use the normal teapot at home. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking.
yeah, it's easy. You have a small teapot, you can use that. It's fine. Perfectly.
So what should be the flow? How slowly you should do it? Not droplets, but single. How quickly we can do it?
See, the water will not flow. The passage is very small. Even if we try to push it, the water will flow outside. It won't go inside. The passage is very small, so it is only that way.
I believe Jalneti has become very popular after the corona has arrived.
Thank you.
Yes.
That was very nice. That was a very nice video.
Yeah. So thanks to he. So before we go ahead, let me, he is Dr. Pavitra. He's a PhD in yoga. And Dr. Pavitra has gracefully, thank you to him to make this video specially for us. And he does Zoom classes.
Right.
So Dr. Pavitra has agreed, like anybody who wants to learn Jalneti, he can help us doing it through Zoom.
Okay.
So, you know, one or two classes, if you do it with him under supervision, then there will be no, like, you know, 100% will be, it's very smooth. There's no problem, but it's better to do it under supervision. So there is no mistakes, you know?
Yeah. And there's no discomfort so that, you know, you can continue doing this practice.
And like we know that, okay, there is somebody to guide us. If you're doing something wrong, then there is somebody. It's always good to start something under guidance.
Absolutely.
So now let's talk about what are the precautions or what are the tips we have to take while doing this. So the first thing is we have to make sure, we have to remember after each nostril, after the kriya done in each nostril, bhastrika or kapalbhati has to be done to remove the excess water. Because if the excess water stays there, then the purpose is not served, because we are going to get the same sinus problem. We are adding water to the sinuses. So that is the first thing. Secondly, the water should be a little bit lukewarm. The lukewarm water helps the mucous membrane inside of our nose. It helps it to clear up faster. The salt again liquefies the mucus. So again, it helps. So when the water is flowing out, basically the mucus is also flowing out with the water. So it's very important.
I have a question, how to contact Dr. Pavitra?
No, I will give you I will share the phone number and you can immediately contact with it. Remember, do not think that I have too much of mucus accumulated in my sinuses, let me add more salt, it will come out fast. Please do not do that. Too much of salt produces irritation in the nose, and there will be a burning sensation and there will be a lot of other issues. So remember to not use more than 1 teaspoon of salt.
In Shilpa, there was also this thing that you should not use cold water or room temperature water. It should only be slightly lukewarm, and there's a reason for that.
Yeah, because see, we are doing this to remove all the mucus from our like nasal passage or from the sinuses. So if you take cold water, the mucus gets frozen. We are asking the mucus to get frozen. So nothing will come out. The water which we send will come out. So that's why when you take lukewarm water helps it to melt. So it immediately comes, it mixes with the water and it comes down.
Right. Yeah. Thank you.
Another important thing is remember to breathe from your mouth when you're doing this, because the nose is busy with the kriya. So keep your mouth open and breathe through. It becomes easy. You won't even realize it, but it's important to breathe. Don't lock your mouth and start doing this. Then you won't be able to do it. You'll get suffocated. So I can again repeat, it helps in sinusitis, allergic rhinitis, headache, migraine, insomnia, because people who have nasal issues, they cannot sleep properly. They also, it helps them, even gray hair, hair fall, everything is taken care of.
Right. Sounds like a very useful practice.
Yes, very useful. And especially, of course, with our virus, if we do it every day. So when should this be done? Okay, I forgot to tell this. This should be done empty stomach. So it's better to, when we wake up in the morning, do it in the morning. It should be done before brushing our teeth. So just do it in the morning itself. I think Anu was...
So how many rounds do we take? Just once each nostril, or how many?
Yes, one round.
Just one is enough.
One is enough, more than enough.
And so, for how long you can pour, not the whole pot? I mean, how much water?
No, so it's normally, this pot takes 100 ml, so it's 50 ml on each side.
Okay, great.
It's 50 ml on each side. So if you're using a teapot or something, then maximum you're taking 100 ml. Or you can make it 50 ml first and then, so that you keep account of how much water you're using.
Yeah, that's very nice.
I think Anu wants to ask something. Are we?
Yeah, Shilpa, I wanted to know, can I do it if I have a deviation in my nose?
Yes, it helps a lot. It works. DNS, it works a lot. It works, and many of them could even, like the surgeries could be avoided.
And that's very good. One more thing, this pot, a pot like this is available in Tokopedia.
Yeah, so the pot is not available in Tokopedia. You get a bottle here.
Okay.
I will show you the picture. I have a picture of the bottle, which works the same.
Dr. Shilpa, I was also suggested this Jal Neti, but they told us that you can even use your palm to take it. Is it possible?
Yeah,
I was taught something like this. So it can be done or not?
No, it is
you
right.
Told that you just have to fill your palm with the water and do it like this. Is it possible? What do you suggest?
It's possible, but it needs a lot of experience. And because, you know, when you have to pull the water in there. If you're doing it, like, you know, in the olden days or back in the villages of India, people still drink water from their mouth.
Yeah.
But it needs a practice. Everybody cannot drink it. Similarly, when you do it like this, you need to know how to tilt, how to make sure the water goes in that direction. So there is a bottle, rubber bottle, which is available on Tokopedia very freely. It's a flexible bottle. It has a spout on top. And then we can just put it and it's like, just keep on pressing it. It's like an oiling bottle. Just press it, press it, press it, and the water goes inside. It's very easily available. I'll show you the pictures later on. I'll give you the contacts and everything.
Do you suggest doing it every morning?
Yes, it is very good. You know, the wrinkles of the face, the acne, the hair fall, you know, all our beauty solutions. Forget about the virus, okay? That's there. But forget about that. You know, this is something I feel this is the time we can incorporate it in our daily life and keep it happening forever. It's not only for the pandemic, it's forever.
Yeah. You look pretty and young, youthful.
Yes, always. Always. Pretty and young forever.
Yes, wonderful.
Okay. So let's move to the third thing we're going to talk about is Gandush. Gandush is, we're going to do something like oil pulling. So we are basically using all the openings on our face. So the openings are the places where the virus can attack us. Easy, simplest way we can think about. Or the other thing we can think about is, because these openings are the only ways we can control our inner toxins also. So we are today trying to use these openings and work on that. So when we talk about Gandush, Gandush means basically it is gargle. It is simple way, it's gargle. In Ayurveda, we use oil for gargling or we use kadha. Kadha is decoction. Decoction is made with herbs boiled in water, reduced, and then we can use that. So, you know, at this point, maybe again, the question is how many herbs are available where you are and how we don't want to go out and all that. So the easiest way is we can also take normal water, add some haldi to it, turmeric to it, and put it in the mouth, leave it in the mouth. See, the thing is leave it in the mouth. It's not like how we gargle after brushing our teeth. That is not what we're talking about. This is to leave it in the mouth and leave it for 15 minutes.
Without moving the internal?
No, you have to move it, but you don't have to squash it. Yeah, you have to squash it. You have to squash it. So it should be slow. It should not be.
Oh, so move it around your face, inside your mouth.
So with that, the wrinkles from outside will go completely. It's an exercise for your muscles. We start from the outer skin. The acne gets healed completely. Inside, when you're inside the mouth, again, all the bacteria are killed. All the gingivitis, bad breath, tooth problems, everything is taken care. Poor dentist will start crying, will say that, oh, the visits, my patients are not coming. You know, it also, the main thing what it does is it brightens your teeth. Because this is what we all want when we are doing, because of the selfie and everything, we are always clicking pictures. And our teeth, we want it to be the best.
Yes. So for teeth, so the liquid inside should be, this liquid inside should be of what temperature?
It's just room temperature. It's just room temperature. Here we don't need heat. So, you know, Ayurveda prefers using oil. Oil pulling is the best. So what we tell is take 1 teaspoon of coconut oil. Just 1 teaspoon of coconut. Start with 1 teaspoon of coconut oil because, you know, then slowly we go to 1 tablespoon. Start with 1 teaspoon of coconut oil. Just put it in your mouth. Leave it in the mouth. Slowly, slowly you're moving it. Because I'm talking...
Yeah,
it's like very slowly. You don't have to do it very, don't do that because, you know, then you will have stiff jaw. We don't want to create more problems. With this, we are exercising the muscles inside. We are making, strengthening our jaws. We are strengthening our teeth, strengthening our gums, and it keeps on. So, you know, maybe when you start it for the first time directly, you won't be able to reach 15 minutes. It will be difficult. So don't worry. Whatever minutes you can manage, which is fine, but by doing this you can divert yourself, start looking at some video or go for a shower, go for a walk, put it in your mouth, keep on squashing and go out for a walk. So that way your attention gets diverted. Otherwise it's difficult, you know, just when you start, it's very difficult to keep the coconut oil into the mouth and like just you will just feel, oh, I want to throw it. I want to.
Yeah,
throw
means it. Even while you're saying it, I can, you know, cannot imagine keeping something in my mouth and, you know, trying to slosh it around for 15 minutes. It is something you have to learn to do.
Learn to do it. Yeah.
Poonam, I have an idea. When in the morning I do oil pulling, I see all my WhatsApp messages and the 15 minutes go away. Believe me.
That's
believe
what I
me, this is what I do.
Yeah, so that is possible. Or you do a walk, you know, you can go and do an early morning walk and just do it. But it really helps. See, what happens is when you use the oil is lubricating. It goes in between your teeth where, you know, the floss cannot go. It works like a magnet. It works like a pump. It pulls all the microbes which are there, the bacteria, the fungus which is there. So everything comes out. And because you're squishing inside, the saliva is continuously generated. Because the saliva is generated, it is again like supporting your digestive system. It's activating your digestive system. So that's why this should be done in the morning. The more it is also, you know, slowly, slowly you realize if you've taken 1 teaspoon of oil, within 15 minutes, it becomes double the quantity because it mixes with the saliva. Now this water or this oil, which is there in your mouth, it is full of toxins because it absorbs all the toxins and it is full of your saliva also. So please avoid swallowing it. Nothing will happen. Nothing will happen. It's not fatal or it's not nothing because, you know, it's our own toxins, but the purpose is not served. We want to throw the toxins out.
Yeah.
So I'll spit it out, 1 minute. And another thing that I want to do is, remember, do not spit it in the sink. It will block your sink. Spit it in a dustbin. Do not spit it in a sink. Otherwise, you will remember me early morning. Oh God, what is this? Okay, tell me.
Okay, so, yeah, please continue.
Okay, so I'm going to share a video and we see how it goes. It's going to tell the same things and then we can go ahead from there.
Yeah.
Is oil pulling done? Try to start your day by doing this before you brush your teeth or drink anything. If not that, do it a few hours before eating dinner. Put a single tablespoon of coconut oil in your mouth and start to swish it back and forth in between your teeth for 10 to 15 minutes. If that's too much for you, try doing it while doing something else like showering or working around the house. Try not to swallow any of the oil while doing this to prevent the toxins from getting back into your body. And make sure you spit the oil into the toilet or a cup because it could clog the drain if you use your sink. After that, immediately rinse your mouth with warm salt water to remove the toxic debris. When you're done, brush your teeth as you normally would.
Okay, tell me.
So coconut oil is the biggest antibacterial oil. So I'm sure it removes all the debris from the mouth. And I think secondly, if by mistake somebody swallows, the stomach acids are going to kill all the bacteria in it. What do you say?
Yes, agree. So see,
coconut nobody oil, is going to die out of it.
Nobody's going to die. They're not even going to fall sick. Nothing is going to happen. See, why I prefer coconut oil is because coconut oil is rich in vitamin E, vitamin A. It also has lauric acid and it is also antibacterial. So it has all the things. But if somebody doesn't like coconut oil, you can also use olive oil. It's fine.
Is there any specific oil to use? Virgin coconut oil or, you know, the regular coconut oil?
See, of course, the virgin coconut oil is, of course, the best because it is cold compressed virgin coconut oil. That is the best. So we get all the qualities. But if otherwise, the normal coconut oil is also fine. No problem.
Okay. Because that was one of the questions.
Yeah. It is, the virgin coconut oil is the best, of course, but if it's not available, which is nowadays it's 100% available, but olive oil, you know, we get cold compressed olive oil also. If somebody's not comfortable with coconut oil, can also use olive oil.
Right.
So it works well.
The right time would be 10 to 15 minutes.
See, yeah. But starting you will not, 15 minutes is maximum you have to do. But it's difficult to reach, like it's not, like firstly you cannot reach it. The best benefit is your teeth will start shining. It will become white. You don't have to go to a dentist. You don't have to get regular cleaning done. 100% you will see the difference. And please do tag me of smiles that, okay, thank you for the oil pooling. Don't forget to tag me.
Good one.
Okay. So anybody wants to ask anything or we go to the next thing?
In fact, I just noticed there was a question on Facebook from Geeta Tong. She wants to know, what if, while this is regarding the Jal Niti, she says, what happens if the whole water doesn't come out?
So there's no problem if the water doesn't come out, even if some water stays there. First of all, we're doing either Bastrika or Kapalbhati, and when we sniff it out, the water comes out.
Force it out.
And even if something stays, it will slowly go back. It will come out through your digestive system. So we don't have to worry.
Okay. Thank you.
So now let's move to the last Kriya for today. That is Netra Tarpan. Now Netra Tarpan is, as it says, we are talking about like nourishing our eyes. Netra and Tarpan. Netra means eyes and Tarpan means we are going to nourish our eyes. So now, you know, at this point, our eyes are the most suffering organs in our body. Because Zoom, online, you know, the 4 months ago, we would say, reduce your screen time, whether it's a child, whether it's an adult, we would tell everybody, reduce your screen time. Now we're telling everybody, oh, why are you not online? You should be online. Everybody is on the screen. Now, because of that, I feel after the pandemic, everybody will be wearing glasses. Their numbers are going to be, it's really damaging our eyes.
Yeah.
So why do we wait for that? So we have to learn some techniques so that we take care of our eyes. So that we can nourish our eyes. Of course, see, when we do this daily, our eyes are nourished. Of course, there are specific, again, medicated oil, medicated water used for special problems like glaucoma, cataract. Even the cataract, the speed of cataract can be reduced, stopped, so the cataract won't grow. So it helps in many ways. It's a very, very simple process, very easy. So we are going to use, see, eye wash cups. Is it visible? These are eye wash cups.
Again, you get it at Tokopedia.
Yeah, this you can easily get in Tokopedia. You can get it in any chemist also. And I have improvised this. If you cannot find this, even if you have a swimming goggle, you can use this. So I will just show you how to do it. For this, there is no video. I could have done it, but I thought it's okay. I thought, let me just talk and do it. So I will just show it in a way and just see it. If there's any doubt, we can. So we use this eye cup. What we do is, if we are using water or we are using ghee, there are two ways to do it. So whatever it is, we fill this 3/4 with water or with the ghee, and then we fit it into the eye. When we fit it, a vacuum is created, okay? So as soon as the vacuum is created, you can tilt your head up and then start blinking. 1, 2, 3, like this 50 times you blink. Then you rotate your eyeballs to the right, left, right, left. So it will be like this. Right, left, right, left. So basically, the eyeball is getting exposed to the oil or the water. And then once it's done, then you come back down and then you remove it. That's it. It's very easy. Nothing to do. It's just, so same thing again, you do it here. So it's a vacuum created. And so how do you do it with the goggles? Fill the goggles, because see, goggles also have vacuum. They create vacuum. So it's easier to use a goggle. Everybody has swimming goggles and it's easily available. So fill this up with the water, medicated water, normal water or ghee, whatever you're planning to use. Keep it here. So put it here, fill it here, and then bring it here. Once you're here and then you've done it here, and then you start blinking. 1, 2, 3. Just blink, 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 rotate your eyeballs, and then you're done. It becomes very easy. So I think it can be very easily done. And this is the most required for ourselves, to make sure our eyes are taken good care. Because see, after our brain, our eye is the most complicated organ in our body. You will not believe, in 1 second, our eye focuses on 50 objects, 50 things. Just imagine how fast it is working. And you know, we are doing the least for our eyes.
My focus is only on you. And my small question is, now somebody's asking, can we mix ghee and water together? I don't think so. What do you say?
No.
So which is a better liquid to do it? Which is a preferred liquid?
See, ghee is very good, but I think ghee, you do it only once a week. Ghee, you do it once a week. For daily use, the best is you use cold water. Cold water. Cold water, you can either put 2 drops of rose water if you have pure rose water. Or if you have trifla powder, pure trifla powder, soak it, strain it with a cloth so that there is no minute particle remaining there. And then use that water. So for daily use, you can use plain cold water. That is the easiest thing. You can add rose essence, like rose water to it. Not essence, I would prefer rose extract. I would rather say 2 drops of rose extract because it's cooling. Eyes are said to be, you know, pith. In Ayurveda, they are pith and they are having a very heaty effect. So we should always cool it down. That's why we are using these things. And again, ghee, normal cow ghee you can use. Of course, there are medicated ghees which are used for special eye problems. But with the ghee, you do it once a week, not always. So back in when I studied, still in the hospitals, what we are doing is we use the, you know, the wheat flour that we make chapati. We make a border with that. We make a person lie down and we make a border with that. And then we put the oil. So it is again, you know, basically, so that's why I thought, okay, these are the easier way to do it. So let's do it that way.
So the question is, what is the difference between the A2 ghee and the regular ghee?
What is A2 ghee? I have never heard about it.
No, I think it was Pavani thought that it was it. It's cow ghee, Pavani.
No, hi Shilpa, Pavani here. I've heard of this A2 ghee, which is here being sold in Singapore. It's, I think, 4 or 5 times the price of regular ghee. And they're saying that is the preferred ghee for Ayurveda. I mean, I've never heard of it. So I just wanted to...
So sorry, I have also not heard about it.
Yeah.
Can you send me the
picture? I can share something.
Okay.
Oh, I can send you the picture, sure.
I can share something on A2 ghee. So A2 ghee is the cold process, some churning process may use. But the key is the kind of cow milk that is being used. So there's a concept of Ahimsa milk these days. And that's the pure original cow milk from the cow without torturing or without putting the cow through all the torment and torture about castor oil and injections and everything. So it's a higher quality of milk. And in A2 also there's another quality called Gir or indigenous, which is coming from the mountain, the old variety, Desi cows. So the highest in quality is the A2 indigenous or A2 Gir ghee. Then there's the A2 ghee, and then there's the commercial ghee. And then of course there is the ghee made at home, but again that depends on the quality of milk that is used. So the milk that we buy typically is not Ahimsa milk, and it's more considered in the category of commercial milk.
Thank you very much, Shalini. I also learned something new today.
Yeah, something new to learn.
Yeah, I switched to A2 indigenous ghee last year, so that's why I know about it.
And where are you buying it, Shalini, if I may ask?
I bought it in India from some place near Bangalore or somewhere, I don't remember. But I was given a call. Actually, Dr. Pavitra told me about it. And he gave me a contact also. It is available in India on Amazon. And also with certain... So there are only very few organizations that are selling this A2 ghee.
Thank you.
So, Dr. Shilpa, the purer the ghee, the better for your eyes. It's something like that.
Yes, of course. The purer the... See, as just now Shalini said, so it is of course better when the ghee is coming from a very, you know, like a free cow.
Yeah, free is the word I was looking for. Free gazing cow.
Yeah, free grazing cows, and also when it comes from there, it is of course much better. So of course, but when we make the ghee, we the way the process is, most of the toxins are gone, but the qualities will depend on the milk quality and the cream quality that is used.
Right. I think these are all things that we don't really didn't know at all. We've heard of the kriyas, but you know, the distinctions are what make it, I think, more useful, the practice, to understand the distinctions.
So that is why, you know, this is what is organic ghee. When we talk about organic ghee, is using the cow from the free. So that's why back in India, not only in India, I see in many countries now, people are trying to develop their own farm. They're having their own cows. They're using their own milk. So that way it becomes, you know, again, we are going back to the square one again, where we came from, instead of buying things, ready-made things, you know, people, because they don't want, because giving hormones to the cow to increase the production has become very common. Unknowingly, we are, even if it's ghee, even if it's cream, even if it's cheese, we are also taking in those parts of hormones with that.
So just to share my experience, Dr. Shilpa had suggested to me, I was having some hydration problem in my eyes, and she suggested some tarpan and ghee. And last 2 months, I have been applying just a very little. So I just take a little bit of A2 ghee. I rub it on my palm to make sure it doesn't have any lumps. And I apply it at night. And I realized a couple of weeks ago that I am not using my spectacles anymore.
Oh, wow.
That's wonderful.
I didn't realize that was happening.
Sorry.
So thank you, Shilpa.
That I tell everybody, if you have the older ghee, so that is one thing I suggest everybody. You take one like small container of ghee and keep it aside. Keep it aside, like make two, three containers and keep them aside. And like you can start using it after 3-4 months because they'll become your old ghee. And for now you use, because you don't have the old ghee, you use that. Apply it on the tips of your eyebrow and also on the tip of your eyelashes, like inside, and you see the difference. You don't have to wear glasses at all.
Whether you have plus number or minus number, any?
Yes, anything.
Really? That's very nice.
Because the eye is a muscle. Basically, eye has got muscles. It's only running on muscles. And ghee strengthens the muscle.
Oh, I see.
Ghee strengthens, because we have to wear glasses because the muscles stop working properly. So the ghee strengthens the muscles and they go back and start doing their work properly. That is it.
Can you please explain once again where to put, Dr. Shilpa?
So it's at the tip of your eyebrow.
Okay.
And inside, like how you put kajal. Okay. That is
inside. Actually, it should be inside. So after that, you won't feel oily, or you have to just go to sleep?
No, it's little bit. It doesn't make it oily. It's very little bit. It's just like it doesn't make it oily. You don't find it doesn't disturb. Maybe Shalini can tell. Shalini, does it disturb you while sleeping?
No. So what I do is I actually put it inside my eye. So I just rub it on my, and I, what I do is I rub it all the way like this, and then I put the rest on the eyelid. And actually, I feel it helps me sleep better.
Yeah.
It relaxes the eye.
Of course, it is like, it is more like it helps, because cow's ghee is relaxing in all ways. So whichever, that's what we say in Ayurveda, we say chidra. In English, we say the openings. God has given us these openings. Use any of the openings and try to put as much as ghee, oil into it and use it. Relax yourself. Soothe yourself.
So, Dr. Shilpa, these days, Corona is also doing this, using us all chidras to get in.
So, that is what this session is for, because these are the only openings from where coronavirus can go inside. So, strengthen these openings, if we make the immunity, if we increase the immunity, then we are taken care. We don't have to worry, because in some day, if we get up with a slight cold, you know, the fear is, oh, suddenly our throat starts irritating because we have a cold. That's all in our brain. But then if you tell yourself, you're taking good care of yourself and nothing can happen, now virus cannot touch me. Ayurveda has come to me, so there is nothing else that can touch me.
So I used to hear from my grandmother, she used to do ghee massage for her hair. How does that help?
So ghee has a soothing, the effect, the ghee has the property, which is one of the effect is soothing effect. It is like pitta shamak. In Ayurveda, we talk about three doshas, vata, pitta and kapha. And it is pitta shamak. So when you do an oil massage, basically the ghee gives you a cooling effect, and that is how the pith goes down and it soothes you. It relaxes your mind.
So we have a question that can these commercial ghees be used like Amul or Britannia or some other brand? Are they as pure? What do you say?
I would prefer at least homemade ghee.
We can make the homemade ghee from buying the butter also. That comes out to be pure.
That is still okay. Just buy, you know, like just buy the butter, put it in the pot, heat it until it becomes ghee and use that. That is still okay. I would not prefer like, you know, any branded, but unless it's an organic ghee, but I would not prefer that.
Yeah, I agree. Yes, Nupur Lohia, your question has been answered. I also feel that this is all more of a marketing stunt. So when it comes to your eyes, let's use the purest. I feel this.
Yeah, even, you know, one more thing you can use is coriander leaf juice.
Okay.
Coriander leaf juice. You can even, for the eye wash cups that I said, yes, you can use the coriander leaf juice. It helps to reduce the eyeglasses number.
Oh yeah.
That's soothing. It also helps in dark circles. So it does help a lot.
That's very interesting.
Actually, we get A2 milk over here. We can try making ghee from that. A2 milk is available in Indonesia. I've seen it many times in the farmer's mart and all.
If A2 milk is available, then we can make our own ghee.
It is available. We can try making the ghee.
So how to make the coriander water, Dr. Shilpa?
So the easiest way is you soak the coriander leaves.
Maybe a handful?
Yeah, a handful is enough because you just need a little bit. It's like, I think 20 ml maximum. 20 ml.
How concentrated should it be?
So it is like, so when the water, it will be 50-50. 50% coriander and water. So you take the coriander, soak it in water, like wash it very well and everything. Then you crush it. Crush it, press it, remove the juice, and equal quantity of juice and water.
Okay. Can you use a mixer grinder and then just strain it through a cloth?
I don't think so.
You can do it if you have a grinder which can grind that small quantity. If you have that, like a grinder which can do the small quantity, it's fine. You can do it. Yeah. Otherwise, everybody, you know, do it in like a wholesale supply for everybody at home. So today, coriander water is made. So everybody has to do netra tarpan, and then it's done.
Good idea.
No, thank you so much, Shilpa. This was a very interesting session, and there were so many, so many interesting and useful things that you have shared with us. I think we have 5 minutes left. So if anybody has any questions, you could type it in or raise your hand and then.
Wanted Dr. Pavitra's number. Yeah, I will just type it in so that everybody can get it. Dr. Pavitra is presently in India, but he is using a WhatsApp Indonesian number. So I will just type it here.
Sorry, can you repeat again the coriander water thing, how to make it?
Yeah, you wash the coriander leaves nicely and then crush it either on a mortar and pestle, or you can grind it in a grinder. And then strain it with a cloth. Strain it with a cloth so that there is no particle remaining. And then the concentration, take equal quantity of the coriander juice and water.
But the coriander was already soaked in the water. So the water content would have gone into the coriander, right?
Yeah, but that's fine. When you crush it also, coriander will have a lot of water, but that doesn't matter. It's okay, a little bit extra water doesn't matter. So it won't have a problem.
So equal quantity of coriander water and water.
Yes, that's right. Why I'm saying is you soak it, because just washing sometimes does not help. I don't want any particles or something, because we are doing things to improve the eye health, not to create problems. So that's why I'm insisting that you soak the coriander leaves.
So soak it for like few hours or just
No. 10 minutes, 15 minutes is more than.
Right, and then take it out, you grind it, then you, whatever water comes out, then you put it with the equal measurement of normal water and then put it under your eyes?
not under the eyes, you put it in the eye wash cup, or you put it under goggles, whatever you're using, and then you do it, do the whole process of nature therapy.
Okay, I think I missed out. I joined the Zoom link later and I think I missed out that. So sorry.
Yeah, I think Poonam will put it right. Poonam?
Yeah, yeah, it's on Facebook. So yeah, you can just go back and see it. So then you will know what needs to be done, Tina. Yes. No worries. And everything is on Facebook, and also there'll be an event report on Endo Indians. So don't worry.
Shilpa, good tips for hair thinning. Can you give us some very good tips, because I have hair thinning problem.
So Aparna, for sure Nasya will help you for hair thinning. And there is another therapy called Shirotarpan. Like we have Netra Tarpan, there is Shirotarpan. Maybe we can do another session to do that. That will surely help you.
Yeah, I would love to. Yes. Yeah,
but meanwhile, you start doing Nasya. Nasya will help you. Just oil, oil, or you can use ghee for your hair fall, it will help. Just 2 drops of ghee every night before going to sleep, and that is going to help you. The hair, you will see the difference, hair fall will stop.
Okay, my hair doesn't fall, but what has gone, it doesn't come back.
No, so you'll see the difference. 100% you'll see the difference.
Okay, great session, Shilpa. It was really nice.
Nice, it would be nice to see you, but I'm hearing you at least, that's good.
I think it was very good in various ways, because not only was it to boost your immunity during the pandemic, but also how you can look more youthful and, you know, actually look after your eyes and you look after, you know, your teeth. I think these were all very, very valuable learnings today, Shilpa. Thank you so much for sharing it with all of us in such simple language and very demonstrative videos, etc. Thank you. And thank you, Geeta, so much for sharing, your questions and guiding the conversation forward.
Thank you so much, all of you. I'm sure after the pandemic, we all will be beauty queens, the way things are going on.
After pandemic, you know, we will all meet and we will show our teeth and we will show our beautiful eyes and beautiful skin. See, you have given us so many tips. So there are food tips, there are activity tips. All together, you know, after the pandemic, we are going to be the beauty queens.
I'm sure. thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Poonam. Thank you very
much.
Thank you. Bye.
I have already shared Dr. Pavitra's number on the chat. You can contact him directly and he will help you to do the Kriya. He is very happy to help.
That'll be great. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shilpa.
Thank you all.